ChatGPT has launched a new plan which is called as Go, and it comes exactly between the free as well as the plus subscription. And the cool thing is this plan has currently launched only in India, and later it will be expanded to all the other parts of the world. As you can see, Sam Altman has officially tweeted about this. He says it's launched in India, making ChatGPT more affordable, and after getting the feedback from India, they are going to expand this to other countries. So earlier, ChatGPT had three plans, which is the free one, and the plus plan comes in $20, and the pro plan, which comes in $200. Now we are having another plan, which is called as Go, which costs around 400 rupees. In terms of US dollar, it will come around $4 to $4.5. So as they clearly say here, right, it has 10 times higher message limits, 10 times more image generation, 10 times more file uploads, and 2 times more memory when compared to the free plan for 400 rupees. So to directly compare the free, Go and plus, there aren't much differences between free and Go subscription. The Go subscription just offers some expanded access compared to the free plan, as I literally explained you a moment ago from this tweet. So we can see this side by side over here. Both gives access to GPT-5, and with Go plan we get expanded access to messaging, uploads, image generation. And with free plan there is limited access. So which means we can upload more number of files or images and ask questions or ask it to edit, and also perform image generation in Go plan very much more when compared to the free plan. And here we are having limited memory and context, but in Go plan we are having longer memory and context, which means ChatGPT will be able to remember our past conversations or past chats in a much more wider way when giving us the response. So that can optimize our response to an extent also. And in deep research, both of them are coming the same. It's limited. And these are the new features that users can use in Go plan, which is projects, tasks, and custom GPTs. So if you want to know more about the projects I have explained in this video, to put it in a nutshell, projects helps us to organize all our chats under a particular topic or a folder, which helps us to keep the context organized. And next, tasks is basically like an alarm or a reminder inside ChatGPT. So to put an example, let's say I'm asking ChatGPT to analyze particular stock before 9 p.m. every day. So whenever I wake up, I will be getting a notification as well as a chat message from ChatGPT saying, hey, it's 9 p.m. and I have analyzed or done this particular task that you have asked. So it can do tasks, and it can also act as an alarm clock or a reminder for us. That's the task feature. And custom GPTs, like, you can able to create and chat with custom GPTs that are specific on a particular area like math or coding problems. So these are the additional features that you are getting exclusively for the Go plan. Now if we compare Go and Plus plan, it's going to be really similar, whereas Plus will have some more extra features than Go. So GPT-5 with advanced reasoning comes in Plus plan, and here also we are having the expanded messaging, image generation and stuff. And the main difference comes over here. First thing is expanded deep research, whereas in Go we are having limited deep research, and we are also having that agent mode. So that agent mode, as you remember, right, ChatGPT can like book hotels, make payments on our behalf, like create PPTs and analyze a particular thing and give us report. That agentic mode operator, that's available in Plus plan, and this feature is already present in Go. And these are the two main features that are not present in Go, which is Sora video generation. We all know about that, like it's a way you can convert your text, your prompts to videos. That's a whole bunch of features. Sora, that's available in Plus plan, not in Go. And we are also having that Codex agent, which can like link with our GitHub and perform code corrections, raise PRs, analyze that code and stuff. That's also available in the Plus plan. Here I am in the official OpenAI help article, and here they have given the differences between the free plan and what you get additional in the Go plan. So you can just pause the video and read it through. And here they have given the difference between GPT Go and the Plus plan. And they have also asked this frequently asked question: will users be able to use the legacy models such as GPT-4o with ChatGPT Go? And they have said no to it. You cannot access legacy models with ChatGPT Go subscription, because a lot of users really liked the 4o. and only the older models of ChatGPT can be used with the Plus subscription. So you can get this particular link and read more about ChatGPT Go. You can just Google ChatGPT Go and you'll be getting this OpenAI Help Center. So if you click it, you'll be getting this exact same link that I'm having, and you can just read it through and clarify your own doubts. So that's basically it, guys. Do let me know in the comments what you think about this new ChatGPT Go. Check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.